some 30 to 32 watches were made by these hand methods during a 30-year period, which is approximately one per year. And I rather began to run out of ideas, and I didn't see much point in going on. Didn't want to make the same watches again. And so I began to lose interest, which seems a curious thing to say, because I had a lifetime's interest in watches. But on the other hand, if it wasn't going to be a challenge, there wasn't any point in it. I'm going to go and do something else. And so then it was that I had a telephone call from Roger Smith, who, a young man, had set out to become a watchmaker, and he'd made his first watch. And he was very complimentary, and he got his ideas out of the watchmaking book, and he'd produced a very presentable watch. Not quite perfect, but very good start. And so we had a talk about it, and he decided he'd go and make it again, which he did, and it was very good. And then, to my surprise, he phoned me again a year or so later and said he'd like to come over and work with me. That's what you said, wasn't it?
No, you asked me, I think.
Okay. Okay. So you said you'd like to?
Yes.
Yeah. And
you were working on the coaxials with Switzerland then?
Yeah, well, I was working on the project with Omega in Switzerland. And once we'd started in Switzerland and we got the EBOSH, that is the basic movement, sorted out and what was going to be done to it, I got 50 movements from them to bring back here to make up 50 watches under my own name, but using the Omega EBOSH and my escapement. And I needed some assistance on this. I didn't really want to make 50 watches myself. And so it was Roger and I got together, and he came and as my assistant and worked on these watches. I had already made the prototype, which I still have, and I'd fitted my own calendar to it and finished it off in the English fashion, and more or less left it to Roger then to get on and make the other 50 watches, which he did very satisfactorily.